A couple days ago, I remember driving past this Rolls-Royce for sale. And then this question sort of popped into my mind. It really wasn't coming from me. It was coming from the Holy Spirit, and it said, "Would you like to drive a Rolls-Royce? Would you drive a Rolls-Royce?" And I said, "Well," just for an instant, I sort of thought about it. I said, "Yeah, I'd do it." And I said, "Huh?" And I was like, "Whoa, where'd that come from?" And I was totally amazed. I said, "I'd do it. Don't want to, you know, but I'd do it if necessary." Driving a Rolls-Royce is a metaphor for being accepting the justice of God is what it's a metaphor for. You elevate, you're elevated. But the thing is, nobody, you know, really wants to drive a Rolls-Royce around. If you really think about it, because you stick out, you're just so conspicuous, you know, totally and pretentious, conspicuous, like, wow, you know, really? It's the most conspicuous vehicle on the road, for sure, and very rare. And so it sets you apart. You're no longer part of the group when you drive a Rolls-Royce. So I said, wow, it would be a very tough thing to do, actually. But yeah, why not? I'd do it. And I said, why not? I'll do it. Then my heart started beating faster, like, oh my gosh, you know. That came from spirit. It was my spirit that said, okay, I'll do it. You know, intellectually, I say, no. That's stupid. Why can't I just drive a normal car? Nobody wants to seem to be, you know, too good for others, right? No. But when you see a Rolls-Royce, you know, it like evokes something. And when you saw it, it's just like, ah. And then, of course, the Holy Spirit could ask each one of us, hey, how about you? Would you drive a Rolls-Royce? And we'd say, oh, no. The Holy Spirit says, why not? Why not? Oh, I'm not good enough. I'm not deserving of that. Really? The Holy Spirit would say, really? You're not deserving? Why are you not deserving? Boy, what's going on? And so at least it puts that question in your mind. It gives the Holy Spirit something to work with. So there's a test for you. If you ask yourself, would I drive a Rolls Royce? Would I drive a Rolls Royce? And nobody would talk with you. You know, the normal people probably wouldn't talk with you. No, nobody would, hardly. They'd say, oh, that, you know, I look like a fool, I'm not successful, or I dislike them, or, you know, just, it seems to distance everything. However, again, it gets them thinking. It gets them thinking, why are they driving a Rolls Royce? Just the way they act, what? In the back of our mind, we'd probably like to drive a Rolls-Royce, really. Nobody will admit to it, of course. But my feeling is like the comfort, the quiet, the smoothness, the peace, the stability, you know, just brings all these things to mind, you know, just this like full stop in the Rolls-Royce, just a full stop. So why wouldn't we want to, actually, if we're honest about it? It's a very good test to put yourself through. People say, how much that cost you? I say, a lot of effort, a lot of effort. They're thinking, huh, can I get it with a little less effort, you know? if you have to ask how much it costs, you can't afford it, actually. Because the effort to uh, resolve the continuity problem, work toward a soft landing into the vision of oneness, that effort is, you know, it just goes on and on. It's just a full tilt effort, full tilt effort. So I would just say, well, I earned it, you know, I earned it. Or better, you know, it was there, it had my name on it. I just had to accept to drive it. He says, you got one with your name on it too, actually. Everybody's got a Rolls-Royce with their name on it in the showroom. You just gotta go in and say, and claim it. This is a beautiful way of putting it, actually. Imagine this showroom, this unbelievably beautiful showroom. And there are these gorgeous Rolls-Royces there. And just, you walk in and you just say, I'd like to claim my Rolls-Royce today. And they say, sure, absolutely, come this way. And there it is, glittering, you know, just on the, just like radiant. And they say, here are the keys, it's yours. I say, thank you very much. Turn it on. Drive it out off out of the showroom, onto the streets, and back to your house. That's it. So just imagine yourself doing that, actually. Because that's very evocative of what the case is. Our state of mind, that is, in full realization that everything knows that time wasn't informed and were never necessary. Everything knows that. We're seeing the end of time where there's a total concurrence. That state of mind of total concurrence is waiting for us. Just like a Rolls-Royce would be waiting for us. The full package Rolls-Royce, you know, the absolute top of the toppermost. It's got everything. Even comes with a driver for you, if you want it. But it's got everything. It's just there waiting for you. You just have to go in, just walk in and claim it. And just say, okay, I'm ready to claim my car. And the staff will say, great. We've been waiting for you. We knew you were coming. We got a heads up you're coming. We've cleaned it. We've prepped it. It's all ready to go. Everything's perfect, ready to drive right off the lot right now. Say, okay, thank you very much. Get in, close the door, adjust the mirrors, turn it on, shift into drive, and drive it off the lot. This is a tremendous guided, tremendous scenario to entertain, to judge your reactions. So, when you do that, everyone wants to know about it, everyone wants to ask about it, everyone wants to get that, everyone wants to have that one too. They want to do it too. Everybody wants to do it too, no matter what they say. They really do want to. And you just tell them, well, yours is there waiting for you. Why don't you go get it? And I say, Oh, no. I mean, how many people really, if you drove home the most incredible Rolls-Royce anyone's ever seen, and you just drive up and park it in your driveway, you say, I traded in my car, they took my old car, this is my new car. Imagine your friends, your family, your neighbors, everybody, drove it to work, drove it everywhere. I mean, what are they going to say? You know. that they are going to, deep down they say, oh my God, I'd love to have that car, but there's no way. If you told them, hey, it's, I saw yours, it's waiting for you. It's waiting for you right there. Just go down and claim it. No. How many people do you know would say, you know what? I'm going to do that right now. I'm going to go down there right now and claim it. How many would really do it? You might get some go down there, and they talk to the staff, and the staff hands on the kid and say, now, wait a minute. And they start talking about, haggling about something. I mean, I don't know. Does that look like a scratch there? Or, I don't know if I know the color, I'm not sure. You know, you sure it's mine? I probably co-own it. Is there a co-owner? You know, well, I'm not really sure. And they wouldn't take it. They'd always come up with some quibble, right? They might go down there, but they would not drive home off the lot with it, would they? The others will say, no way, too good for me. Others will say, well, yeah, I'll go down tomorrow. That's what many. So there's a lot of them who will say, I'll go down tomorrow, next life. I'm almost, yeah, I'm just not quite ready. I'm going to go down soon. Soon, tomorrow, today, but I just want to talk about it. And it's really not a question, well, I don't know how to drive it. That's not true. It's not true at all. The vision of total concurrence, it's not a question of how do I drive it, no. You just drive it like any other car. Put it in drive. Put your foot on the accelerator, put your foot on the brake. That's it. You got it. It's not an issue at all. Now, I've been trying to go down to that dealership for my entire life, every day of my life. I say, today is the day I'm going to do it. So if someone asked me, how'd you do it? Well, I tried to do it every single day, and I chickened out every single day. So I just kept working on my resistance, you know, just kept working on it. Practice, try to find some way to wear that resistance away. So don't let anybody fool you and they say, well, no, I don't want that. Yes, they do. They just have this resistance to it. And you say, look, I know you want it, and I'm here to help everyone. So, you know, there's, I'm not going to spend any time you telling me you don't want it, because I know how good it is. I know you actually want it. There's no question. This is what you really want. This is what you truly deserve. Everybody deserves it. Everybody, God has a Rolls-Royce for everybody, figuratively speaking. Has the formless, total concurrence. Time, space, and form were never necessary whatsoever. They're actually meaningless. Total concurrence is all just a joke we played on ourselves. So God has that vehicle, Rolls-Royce, waiting for everybody. And eventually everybody has to go in there and drive it off the lot. Everybody has to do it. So from that standpoint, I'll say, yeah, sure, I'll do it, sure. Course, because everybody has to do it, so, you know, what's the big deal? I got to do it too. No, I'm no different. To not do it is to assert that you're different, that you don't have to, that somehow you're greater than God, and you don't have to accept any gifts from God, right? You don't have to do anything for God or for yourself. You think you're a new creation, a new creator, and don't have to do it. Not true. So it's really arrogance to not do it. It's very much so. That you can somehow avoid what God has given you? Is that possible? Can we avoid what God has given us? Is that true? Can we avoid dropping the prank we're playing ourselves? Is that true? We'll play it forever. Is that really true? Or is it arrogance? It's arrogance. So it's really non-arrogance to go in there and drive the Rolls-Royce off the lot. And you have to see it that way. It's very humbling, you know. Yeah, I cannot be God. I have to accept the gifts of God. The gifts of God are mine because God has given them to me. There's not, I got no choice. Now the other people thinking they got some choice. The ones who drive the Rolls-Royce out the lot are the ones who simply realize they don't have any choice in the matter. God's given us this. This is the gift that God's given us. That gift is eternal. We cannot reject it. We cannot reject it. No more so can we reject God. Nor more so can we reject reality. Nor more so can we reject ourselves. No more so can we reject truth. We can't. We can't reject it. We can disassociate from it. Believe we're disassociated. But it's eternal. It stays with us forever. So we have to accept the gifts of God. There's no way around it. So it's very humbling to realize, wow, you know, everybody else thinks they can reject the gifts of God, but I've realized, no, I cannot. So why keep wasting time failing to do what I have to do? This is stupid. Just wasting time. So you would think that people would be overjoyed, you know, to experience the total concurrence. Space, time, and form are totally unnecessary. But really, it's very humbling. It'd be very humbling, I would say. And kind of like, wow, what a kind of a burden in some ways, too. Because everybody's going to think, well, what's the matter with you? You know, you're not good enough, huh, to reject these gifts. We got something better. Of course, the whole prank is that we think death is better than eternal life. So we're trying to learn to appreciate. They say, oh, what's the matter with you? You dropped out, huh? You settled for God, huh? You don't think you can hack this course, huh? You can't take it? You can't learn to love and appreciate and value death? See, we're superior to you, they're saying. We're learning. It's taking a long time. It's a lot of effort, but you're lazy. You don't want to put the effort in. I say, no, actually, I put the effort in to realize that it's impossible. And that's a lot of effort to realize that. So, trying to accomplish the impossible, what is that except whim? It's just whim. And God did not create us to remain whimsical forever. So God wants us to drop the whimsy. You know, He has a gift for us so to help us drop the whimsy. So I cannot reject God's gifts for me. No more so can you. Nobody can. So I put a lot of effort into that. I wasn't lazy at all. And everybody else has to do that also. And of course, people will take a, you know, high stance of their own efforts to love, appreciate, and value death, saying, "Oh, we're, you know, I've made a lot of progress. I'm going to succeed at that." You know, it's continuity problem talking there. Continuity problem talking there. So of course, people will not be easy at ease with it. You know, how come you got a Rolls-Royce and I don't? And they won't accept the explanation really, but really they do want it. They're just a continuity fear is talking for them. Knee-jerk reaction. Continuity fear, knee-jerk reaction. So you gotta let things get past the knee-jerk reaction stage in people. Because everyone will have like an automatic response. They'll run some little, you know, trick on you or something, and their defenses will be there. And then, you know, they'll start being a little more honest at some point. Maybe it puts the pressure on them to be honest when they're really challenged by something like this. It's like, wow. They might feel the challenge. Oh, wow, there's a challenge in there. I haven't met this challenge. What is this challenge? Well, it's the challenge of the continuity fear. It's the challenge of turning from trying to love, value, and appreciate death to accepting the gifts of God, the experience of total concurrence. Total concurrence. One perspective, one perception, the perception that all of this form, time, space, totally unnecessary. It was just a joke. Total concurrence. Everyone's on the same page. Everything's on the same page. It's absolute concurrence. experience that. We have to experience that. I definitely can't be lazy and still get to that. That is for sure. So, yeah, all this taping, and there's stuff going on in the world. It's just, you know, the whole world is all happening, and I'm just here taping. That's it. Got to make a decision. You know, what's important? What's valuable? The gifts of God are ours forever, and we cannot ignore them forever. So, I'm going to keep trying to go into that dealership. You keep trying to go into that dealership, too. No haggling. They have the keys just waiting for it. They're in the ignition. Just get in the car and turn it on, and it's it. It's yours. Free title. It's yours permanently. God gave it to you. There's a sense of total concurrence. You're aware of this total concurrence. No matter what the dance is in the world, you have this sense of total concurrence. You know there's a total concurrence in time. So it doesn't matter what's happening in time. You know in time that total concurrence is there from the Holy Spirit. Therefore, you can feel it right now. Doesn't matter what superficial appearances of the changes and everything. That doesn't matter. There is total concurrence in time. And so you can feel that way no matter what's going on in the world. Doesn't bother you in the slightest bit. That's the Rolls-Royce of your mind. And that's it for this video.